Here's an update on the trailer for everyone. If you remember back when I first showed you the trailer, it had no ramps and it had a bit of a gap there in the tire pads. I have now fixed both of those problems, starting with the simpler of the things. Just some sheet metal right here. It's before this was big, a hollow gap. The people who used it before me used construction vehicles on here, and they had big tires and didn't have to worry about that gap. Well, if you're running a compact car with little donut tires, they're going to get stuck in that, or if you have a bare rim. So I actually have steel strapping underneath this, going this way on both sides. Then I have sheet metal laid on top of that so it can support the weight. And I'm in the process of just adding some more welds along here. It's rain, so there's a little bit of rust cover on the surface, but nothing bad. This whole area is going to get repainted once I get around to getting paint for it. And I have my ramps, which I am very happy with how they turned out. These were just a completely homemade idea of mine. Did not have any ideas from anyone else. Didn't really look on the internet. Just kind of went for it and winged it as I went. The hardest part was actually figuring out how to make them swivel to kick up and down without having a weak point on the trailer. So when you make ramps swivel, it puts all the weight of the car driving on it onto that one swivel point for just a brief little couple seconds when you drive on. Hopefully these will be able to handle the abuse and weight. If not, I have a couple ideas of how to reinforce them. I'll find out once I test drive a vehicle on it. So what I did was actually took some pretty thick steel and put pieces of flat stock out here. I had random all thread laying around. That was a fine thread all thread. If anybody knows anything about thread patterns, mostly all thread you find in stores is the coarse style of threading. For some reason, this one was fine threaded. I got it off a scrap pile long ago, and just a pain in the butt to get nuts for it because it's a different thread pattern. So why not use it for something here? So I used that as my pivot point, just the all thread. Found a steel pipe that was pretty thick, and that's going to be my pivot. Slid that like a collar around the all thread before I welded it on. Do that to both sides. Then everything else is just completely angle iron, as I'll show you the underside here in a bit. And because of the very nice dovetail on this trailer, I did not need that long of a ramp. Pretty short. I think these are only 2 foot or 2.5 foot long, which is great. It's lightweight, easy to move around. So let me show you here how they pivot up. Now, I have not officially finished my mounting style to lock them in place once they're folded up. I will be designing two different brackets to mount it on, because currently, you can actually, the way these turned out, I didn't think they'd be able to do this. These ramps fold completely up onto the trailer, laying flat down. Nothing sticking in the air. They are flush with the trailer right there. And it's still perfectly fine on that pivot point because this pipe I put it through has big enough diameter, gives it that clearance to do this on both sides. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make one locking pin for this style. If I want to fold them up flat, lock a pin in them, and they're good to go. But let's say I had a vehicle or even two vehicles that was really long on this trailer, and they're having the vehicle actually back here. Maybe the tires are sitting here or something else is in the way, and I can't fold these ramps up like that. Well, that's where I'm going to have a second system designed where I can have the ramp actually up and hanging in the air like some trailers have. And I'll have kind of a chain or maybe a pivot tab that pops in place, whatever. I haven't got around that far yet. All I know is for the first time to use this trailer, for the compact derby coming up with the Cutlass, that car will be up there on the trailer and these can fold up flat. So that'll be the first style I'm going to use. If these do have problems with this mount and too much weight trying to make it bend, if I see any stress fractures on it or anything like that, I may put kick down legs on the ramps like you see some trailers have. Just right there. It'll come down vertical right here with a leg on the ground. That does help support a lot of the weight from pulling off the trailer there. And even then, those legs won't stick up too high if I fold these ramps backwards. So, what do you guys think? This a good idea? Will it work? There's a few small things I'm going to change still. There's more welding to be done. Right now, this is all just tacked into place up there on the trailer. These ramps are 100% welded. I may, if I run into problems, this one has kind of a big gap between these. I may put some extra scrap steel between these going vertical just to keep more tire grip. And if this smooth surface provides to be a problem with tires sliding when driving up the ramp, I may put just a couple little bumps of metal all over the place, just like a little grip. I'm not sure what I'd use, just random scrap laying around. I'll just weld them on there just to give traction when the tire drives up the ramp. But those are just feature improvements from the original idea. So there you guys have it. My trailer is pretty good to go now. I don't think there's anything different I want to do. I may change the wheel well style here. These are really crappy. If I mentioned that in the first video, I don't remember. Thin. The aluminum diamond plate looks nice, but they're so thin and they're going to break apart. So I may beef them up and put my own on there. Stay tuned, guys. This is one more project out of the way and time to get back to work on the car.